I just love the fact that you can A, go faster than any normal person would on the slopes, and it's just a sense of freedom. And I think I've probably clocked it around 80 kilometres. I know the really fast guys can go around 120 kilometres in a sit ski down the mountain, so you can go pretty fast. it's scary, but you're kind of, you're too caught up in the speed, and if you start thinking, I'm going to crash, you're probably going to crash, because you're going to pull off some dodgy move or something. My name's Victoria Pendergast, I'm 22 years old, and yeah, I live in East Cosford and do alpine skiing.
Come on out.
My disability is sacral agenesis, which just means that the sacral bit of the spine is missing. So basically just affects kind of my lower limbs and some of my kidney functions. Just meaning I have less muscle and yeah, just kind of impaired from down, waist down. Just makes things maybe a little bit harder. So biggest thing for me is going to tall places and maybe trying to reach for things at the very top of the cupboard makes things a bit challenging. But otherwise, it doesn't restrict me too much. Like, I can drive using hand controls and try and find relatively normal work, but standing up for long periods is restrictive because my back gets sore and all that. Everyone thinks that we need help all the time. And I think the misconception is we won't ask if we need it. But I mean, if we need help, we'll ask. I think it would be more difficult driving with pedals. I mean, for you, you'd be like, oh, that's so complicated. But for me, it's like, oh God, pedals, how do you even put pressure on these things? So I don't think it's that bad, but I think it's just once you learn to do something, that's what the normal is for you. And then I guess there's the misconception that we can't do certain things, but I mean, we go do things normally, and if anything, we poke fun at ourselves more than other people do, so everyone's just a bit too sensitive towards the issue. Well, we call ourselves skimps. So if there's a disabled park, we're like, oh, just go in the gimp park. And people are like turning around going, you can't say that. And you're like, yeah, but we can. We're just poking fun at ourselves. Like, if we couldn't do that, I mean, we'd take ourselves too seriously and life would just become a bit too depressing. Probably the most challenging thing was my first downhill race, just because downhill is the fastest event and it's essentially like turns that are really long. No matter how many times I've done the hill or how many times I've been in a race, you still get the butterflies in the stomach. I think some of the best moments it was when I got my first medal after doing a race. That was pretty enjoyable, just the satisfaction, and it was my first World Cup ever. When we're off snow, it's going to the gym a couple of times a week and making sure we keep up the fitness through there. I hate losing, so. I mean, I used to play chess with my dad and I just got so sick of losing to him. I'm just like, I'm not gonna play with you anymore. I hate losing, why would I do this? Yeah, I'd say I'm a competitive person.
Could I please get a fresh orange juice, please?
My goal is to be the best in the world. I'm improving. I think I've still got a way to go. The best ones are maybe 30, so I'm still 8 years off them. But I think maybe, you know, give a couple of years and I could be there, yeah. I don't get to see my family as much as I'd like, and I miss out on certain things happening with my friends, but in the end, you know, what you're doing is pretty awesome.